Hello, today we are going to study the MEMS micro machining process LIGA. Broadly, the micro machining is classified into two types, surface and the bulk, but there is a third form also, which is more popular nowadays for forming the high aspect ratio structures. The process is termed to be the LIGA. The term LIGA is an acronym for a German term in lithography, galvanoform, F-form. Lithography, electroformic molding. The technique was first developed at the Karlsruhe Nuclear Research Center in the Karlsruhe, Germany. LIGA process is radically different from the silicon-based micromanufacturing. The major difference is that the LIGA can produce microstructures that have high aspect ratios. There is no restriction on using silicon or silicon compounds as substrate. Nickel is a common material for the LIGA products. It's easier to be used in the large volumes. The major disadvantage of the LIGA process is a requirement of special facility known as synchrotron radiation X-ray source, which is a very expensive facility. Here, because we have to make the deep trenches in the photoresist layer, so the X-ray radiation required should be of high intensity and the power synchronized radiation. So instead of using a normal X-ray source, we have to switch on to the synchrotron radiation source. What are the major steps in a LIGA process? Broadly, we can classify that the LIGA fabrication process is composed of five major steps. The first one is the exposure using the X-rays, then the development, third one is the electroforming, then stripping, and fifth one is the replication. So first of all, we give a deep X-ray lithography that is provided by the synchrotron radiation facility. After this, the photoresist with the desired patterns is formed on the substrate material using a mask made up of quartz with gold plating generally. Then the electroplating of the metal on the patterns is done. So we get a metal byproduct or a metal molds, usually with the nickel linings. And finally, the plastic products by the injection moldings or the replicable molds, metal products can be formed. As we can see in the figure, we want to make a high aspect ratio structure of a metal in the form of a gear. So what will be the majorly steps? First of all, we will cast a PMMA, polymethyl acrylate, on the metal. Then we will take a mask of the desired structure, and using the X-ray radiations, we will etch away we will form the desired structure. Then the exposed part is developed. So the PMMA will be reduced and electroplating will be done of the desired metal. Once the electroplating is done, all the structures that are being formed by the mask the metal will be deposited there. And in the final step, that is step number 5, the whole PMMA has been developed and been removed. So we can get a high aspect ratio metal-like structure. What materials have to be used for the substrate in this LIGA process? Substrate in the LIGA process must be electrically conductive to facilitate subsequent electroplating over photoresist mold. Metals such as steel, copper plates, titanium or nickel can be used. Silicon with thin titanium or silver chrome top layer or a glass with thin metal layers can also be used. The basic requirements are that the photoresist material must be sensitive to X-ray radiation, must have high resolution and resistance to dry and the wet etching, must have thermal stability up to 140 degrees Celsius. The unexposed part must be absolutely insoluble during the development. Good adhesion to the substrate during electroplating. PMMA appears the most popular for the LIGA process, but other polymers can also be used. In the table, all the other polymers have been compared regarding their properties. Electroplating of the metal is done. The inner surfaces of the photoresist mold produced by the X-ray lithography need to be plated with the thin metal layers for securing the permanent microstructure geometry. The metals available for the platinum are generally the nickel, copper, gold, nickel, iron alloy or nickel tungsten. In the form of plating with nickel, the process is nickel ions are produced from the electrolysis of nickel chloride solution and then they are attracted to the electrons at the cathode. For example, Ni+2+2 electrons form nickel. There could also be H plus ions present at the same cathode in the process. These H plus ions may form H2 bubbles on the cathode and thus nickel plate. Proper control of the pH in the solution is important to mitigate this. So this is the comparison between a bulk micromachining, surface micromachining and the LIGA process. The bulk micromachining, it is less expensive in the process, but the material loss is very high. Suitable for the microstructures with simple geometry, limited to the low aspect ratio in the geometry. As far as surface is concerned, surface micromachining is concerned, it requires the building of layers of materials over the substrate, complex masking design in the productions, etching of the sacrificial layers is necessary, not always easy and wasteful also sometimes. The process is tedious and more expensive. There are serious engineering problems such as interfacial stresses and stiction. What are the major advantages? Not constrained by the thickness of the silicon wafers, we can go through it. Wide choices of the thin film materials that can be used, suitable for the complex geometry such as the microwaves and actuators. The LIGA process, it is the most expensive in initial capital cost, requires special synchrotron radiation facility for deep X-ray lithography, micro injection molding technology and facility for mass productions. The major advantages are virtually unlimited aspect ratio of the microstructure geometry. As we can say, high aspect ratio can be formed up to 1000 or more. Flexible in the microstructure configurations and the geometry, the only technique that allows the production of the metallic microstructures. Thank you.